We haven't said in what order we order these points in the separate subdomains. And therefore, what we can do is say, well, what if we do the same trick, but recursively? What if we take this as a separator here, and this as a separator right here? What that would mean is that within this block and this block, we recursively get the same kind of arrowhead shape. And obviously, you can keep doing this. And this approach for a regular domain like this can be analyzed to show great advantage when it comes to avoiding computation. And like I said, importantly, it also exposes an opportunity for parallelism. The method is known as nested dissection. And if you think about it carefully, even if you have a much more complex domain like this, what it really boils down to is trying to find separators that separate roughly equally the graph into two parts that are not connected, and to then do that recursively. Now, you could say, well, that means that we can only do this if we understand the graph that underlies the problem, but there is this connection between the non-zero pattern in the matrix and the graph that describes that connectivity. So even in artificial situations where you're only handed the matrix and you don't know where it came from, that matrix encodes in its non-zero pattern a graph, and you can then use that non-zero pattern to actually perform this kind of nested dissection. It's still a direct method, because what we described was how we can then take advantage of the zeros to avoid computation that we would perform in a direct method, but it allows us to take advantage of the sparsity that naturally exists in the problem or in the matrix.